بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah, the Lord, Cherisher and Sustainer of the world, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, the Master of the Day of Judgment. All praise is due to Allah, and Allah's peace and blessings be upon His last Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, His pure family, His loyal companions, and all those who follow them with righteousness and good deeds until the Day of Judgment. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah Almighty said in the Holy Quran that He created the human soul on a straight form, on the best form. And the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam clarified that each newborn is born with al-fitrah, the correct innate belief and understandings or insights. However, Allah Almighty at the same time says that He enabled this human soul to take a choice. And Allah Almighty said that He showed this human soul both ways, the way of righteousness and the way of sin, the way of goodness and the way of evil, the way of heaven and the way of hellfire. And that is why human beings are unique. They have this choice. And this is a huge responsibility. Now, the way to win is very simple. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarified also in the same verses that anyone, the one who will succeed, is the one who purifies this soul. And the one who will lose, God forbid, is the one who deceives it, makes it follow its own whims and desires. Now, we will speak about the concept of self-control in Islam. I'll try to summarize some of the important points in this, because if you control yourself, you will succeed, inshallah, in this world and the hereafter. If you will not be able to control your own soul, then most likely you will not succeed, neither in this world nor in the hereafter. Now, the main point Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned is to control yourself from its own whims and desires, what it likes. Now, this might be baffling. What do you mean I have to control myself from what I like? Yes, but what is meant here by what you like is what she likes from the forbidden things, not the permissible ones. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, say who made forbidden what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made permissible from the goodness in this world that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for people. So this is not forbidden. We are talking about the whims and desires that are forbidden. So step number one, control yourself from the things that it likes, which are forbidden. Because if you leave it as it wants, your soul does not like everybody. This is the human soul. Normal human soul does not like to tire itself, does not like to endanger itself, does not like to undergo burdens and chores and works, does not want to work hard and study and progress. That is not the main nature. Usually it wants to relax. It wants to be in the comfort zone all the time. It wants to follow only the whims and desires. So that is when you have to train it and be in control over it to guide it to what is good. And this way you will succeed, inshallah. The second one is controlling yourself during anger. And this is actually the main battle between you and your soul. The biggest battle all the time. Why it is important is because if danger overtakes you, then you will not be in your correct state of mind, and you will not be able to take good decisions or make right choices. Now, a man came to the Messenger Muhammad ﷺ asking for advice, but he says, I want it to be very short. Give me an advice, but make it very short. The Messenger Muhammad ﷺ said to him, don't be angry. I said, okay, a little more. I didn't ask only for one word, a little more. The Messenger Muhammad ﷺ repeat. He said, don't be angry. I said, okay, a little more. I says, don't be angry. Main thing, that man needed this advice very much. So the people who are not in control of themselves. So he guided him. Don't be angry. If you can control yourself at this moment, you are a strong person. You have a good willpower. Else, no. That is the criteria, actually. Somebody who has good willpower, good ability to control himself or not. The Messenger Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, a strong person is not the one who is strong in wrestling. That is the exact wording of the Messenger Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Translate. Not the one who is strong in wrestling, but the one who controls himself during anger. Can't control himself? Yes. Because at that moment, yourself is at its outrageous point. If you can still control it at that time, you're a strong person. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise those who control their anger. Praise it a lot. Forget about what they tell you. If there is an anger, let it go. Shout it out. Say, this is rubbish. All of this is rubbish. Everybody can do that. We're talking about being in a higher state, not the states of animal, a state of human being. Can't control, don't worry. Now, they say it is dangerous to hold the anger. No, it is dangerous to hold the anger if you are not holding it willingly. You are holding it because you are afraid. You are holding it because you fear you will lose something. You are holding it because you are afraid of fines. You are afraid of any kind of things. That is probably not a good thing. But the concept of holding the anger here from the Islamic point of view, you hold it willingly for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially while being in the state of able to invoke this anger. You are the boss, and one of the employees anger you, and you still hold your anger. There's absolutely nothing upon you. You can actually follow that anger. Or your children, or somebody. You are the one who is in control. You can actually follow this anger. There will be absolutely no consequences upon you. You are not afraid of anyone or anything. But still, you control it. Why? For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about those that they control their anger, although they are able to invoke that anger. They control it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the criteria. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Almighty will call them upon all people, in front of all people in the hereafter, to choose from Al-Hur Al-Ain, whatever they like. Are able to, but they are controlling it. Now, keep in your mind that the concept of controlling anger, it is very important for you. Not only for people around you, but first and foremost for you, yourself. Because most likely, whatever thing you say, and whatever things you do at a moment of anger, you will regret it later on. You will regret it. Unless if you are in control of yourself. If you are in control of yourself, you still control your tongue and control your hand and action, no problem. A man came to Salman radiallahu anhu, one of the companions of the Messenger Muhammad. He said, asked him to advise him, and he advised him not to be angry. He said, I am overtaken by anger. It is not in my hand to control it. Anger overtakes me. Something changes in me when I am angered. Then Salman radiallahu anhu tells him, okay, if this happens to you, you have to do two things. Be careful about your tongue and your action, your hand. Okay, you say something inside. You cannot tell, okay, fine, but you can control your tongue and your hand, no? So this is the limit. Because people who claim, you know, I cannot control my anger and it's out of my hand, they say, all of this, they are tricking themselves. This is a trick from shaitan. Everybody can say that. It's very easy to be angry. Concept to it. And everybody, at a certain moment, if he's afraid from a fine or punishment or in front of his boss, for example, or somebody beyond and so on, when he is in a certain situation, he will control his anger for sure. He'll be able to invoke that. So you can control it at the moment. So that is why here, okay, fine. You say you are outraged or something, okay, fine. Now, step number two is not say anything bad and not do anything bad. That angers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many, many more points, but we will summarize, inshallah, with some of the ways to be able to control yourself. We can summarize first the points of controlling yourself, as said by Al-Hasan al-Basri radiallahu anhu. And he says, anyone who wants to be protected from shaitan, and Allah Almighty protect him from hellfire, he should control himself at four times, four positions. at times of want, when you want something, when you wish for something, and times of fear, when you're afraid of something, and at times of desires, whims and desires and lust and so on, and at times of stinginess, when you are longing for something. And so at these times, if you control yourself, inshallah, Allah Almighty will protect, because those are the key to evil. This is the beginning of every evil. Every moment of this, that is a moment of evil. So if you follow it, God forbid, it will take you to something bad. And if you control yourself and not do anything that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Almighty will protect you. Now the ways or the methods of controlling yourself starts first and foremost with understanding yourself and people and your relationship in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep in your mind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He created you and He created them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you this way and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them this way. So do not mock people, do not ridicule them, do not say bad things about them. And if you see someone doing some bad things or sins, or do not belittle him, belittle the sin, not the person. As a person, you treat him as a patient. You treat him as a patient. So you wish for his wellness, inshallah. You pray for his guidance. And you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for not being like him. So this is the first thing. Do not think that you are better than others just because apparently you seem better. That is the wrong thing. This is the key in the beginning. When a person starts becoming arrogant and belittling other people, God forbid. And then later on, that is when he will start doing bad things and saying bad things. And also controlling your speech, your words, whatever you say. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us and to speak goodness to people. Speak in the best possible manner to other people. He didn't say to believers, he said to people, to everyone. And the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, anyone who believes in Allah Almighty and the hereafter, let him say something good or remain silent. If you say something good, you will get reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you remain silent, you will save yourself from humility, from punishment, from harm, from anything, from the consequences, whatever might happen. And also realizing your duty towards other people of advice and good companionship and good treatment and mutual respect and so on. Now, keep in your mind that self-control has many benefits for you as well as for the society. And we can summarize these. The first one, this self-control is the first step in becoming a wise person. You want to become a wise person? The first step or the most important part of wisdom is to control yourself. Wisdom is not by tongue only, how nice you say things. That is not, this is wisdom talk. But real wisdom is, the first part is controlling yourself. And the second part, the second thing that is good for you as well, is that it will increase your willpower. It will increase your willpower and self-consciousness. And this way you will start concentrating on what is important for you in this world and the hereafter. And you will stay away from many of the things that waste your time and your life and your reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third point is that it will increase love and intimacy and compassion within the family and within the society and people around you. You'll become a better person in their sight and a better companion and a better friend. And this is very important on the individual level as well as on the society level. As well as you will be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we have mentioned in some of the hadith and the verses from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Almighty loves those who control their anger and control their emotions and desires and whims and so on and so forth. And you will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. These things Allah Almighty loves them a lot. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that a person never takes a bite, swallows something that is dearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than swallowing his anger for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Swallowing the anger for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to keep this limit all the time. You are swallowing the anger in front of, not because you are, as we said, of any materialistic benefit, but because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Final point of high importance, which is controlling yourself with your children. and with your family. But specifically the children, because sometimes children are at the lowest end within the family. So when there is a problem, sometimes the anger is directed toward them. Even if they are the cause of that problem, you should be careful when you are dealing with children. Because they are at a learning process. They are in the very beginning. They are basically innocent. Even if they do mistakes, Allah Almighty will not hold them responsible for that till they become adults. So you have to be gentle with them, nice with them, deal with them with respects, mutual respects and understanding. And especially at their time of teenage years. And we have examples from the action of Ibrahim alayhi salam with his son Ismail alayhi salam when he became of an age, when he became an adult as a teenager nowadays. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, when Allah Almighty ordered him to carry that sacrifice, which is a major test for Ibrahim alayhi salam, he went and consulted his son Ismail alayhi salam. So this is very important, the importance of discussion and consultation. Although this is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the order was given to Ibrahim alayhi salam, not to Ismail alayhi salam, but it concerns him, and that is why he went and discussed it with him. And subhanallah, Ismail alayhi salam went along with that, and he didn't object to the test. Now, we have another point that is very important, which is do not disrespect them. And this is important. Especially not in front of the rest of the kids or the family or in front of their children or neighbors and so on, or their friends. And we have one example of the concept of respecting children and paying special attention to them, because some of them might be sensitive. And we have the example of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu, his son and grandson Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu, the son of Ali radiallahu anhu, and Fatima, the daughter of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu used to play a lot with the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam during Salah and off Salah. And the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved to play with him a lot. He and Al-Husayn radiallahu anhuma. Now, one day Abu Bakr radiallahu anha, he reported that I saw the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the pulpit, on the minbar. And beside him was Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu, child. And he used to look at people and look at Al-Hasan. So part of the importance is given to people and part of it is given to Al-Hasan. And then he will say, this son of mine is Sayyid, a master. This son of mine is a master. Sayyid, as the Messenger Muhammad said, he and Al-Husayn radiallahu anhuma are the masters of the youth of paradise. This son of mine is a master, and Allah Almighty will, with him, will reconcile between two major groups of Muslims, which happened at the time of Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu, when he became an old, and he withdrew from Al-Khilafah and gave it to Muawiyah radiallahu anhu and aided the fight that was there between Muslims with this Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu. But our proof here is how the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is praising Al-Hasan in front of people, respecting him and showing his position and his importance in front of people. And this is a glimpse of some of the guidelines that we need to keep in our mind. It doesn't mean you do not train them and educate them and be stern sometimes with them as required. So you have to keep that balance all the time. But the most important part is not getting angry, not losing your mind, and not losing whatever control over what you say and what you do, because, God forbid, you might regret it later on. Saying or doing anything at a moment of lack of self-control, most likely you will regret it. And Allah Almighty warned us about the two brothers of Adam, the two sons of Adam alayhi salam, the two brothers, the sons of Adam alayhi salam, when they are good. And one of them was in control of himself. And he says, I'm not going to say anything. Even if you try to kill me, I'm not going to do anything that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one lost control of himself. And he says, no, I'm certainly going to kill you. And he lost control of himself. فطوعت له نفسه. And his spirit, his soul, which went into the bad way, he is no longer in control now. It is pulling him and pushing him. So that is why Allah Almighty said, فطوعت له نفسه. And his soul made it easy for him to carry this. Because now it's in that area. It is in control, not him, God forbid. So it made it easy for him to commit that crime. So he killed his brother, God forbid, and he became one of the losers. He lost this world and the hereafter. Because he was not in self-control. So So that is why it is very important for us to recognize that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to His divine truth, make us good for ourselves and everyone around us. Ameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathira.